Good afternoon, internet. It is 5:30 in the afternoon, evening, and welcome back to the channel. It is already dark here in the Netherlands, so it is so time to leave the country. I am so excited. Today is really the first step in getting back to South America. I'm going to do it the same way as I did 2 years ago. I just realized that 2 years ago I did the same thing, going to Argentina to start the Patagonia Alaska trip, which of course I couldn't finish then. And now I'm going via a similar route, or in the sense that I'm first going to bring my motorcycle to the UK, and then from the UK my new friend Alaska is going to fly back to South America. So that is going to be the first step. So I'm going to ride now to Hoek of Holland and then catch the overnight ferry to Harwich. I think I said that wrong 2 years ago as well. I still haven't learned how to pronounce it, but anyway, to the UK and then ride to Heathrow and drop off Alaska. So that's the plan. I'm now first going to put on my raincoats because I have a feeling I'm gonna catch some rain on the way to the ferry.
Let's go! Bijna aangereden, we zijn er niet weg. So I immediately start off the new season with something that I rarely do and do not like, which is riding in the dark. It's about an hour ride to the ferry and then boarding starts, I think, at 7 o'clock. Have to go. Yeah. Can't remember this from last time at all. I should have watched my video from the beginning of season 2. Then I would have known where to go. I have no idea. I'm not sure if I'm in the right place. This seems to be any trucks. Let me ask here. Oh, they've just ordered a pizza. Okay, wrong place. See, I was looking at all those trucks thinking, But yeah, I have to be just over there. Kijk, wat heb je allemaal nodig?
Een paspoort alsjeblieft.
Ja.
Vaccinatiebewijs of coronatest en een passenger locator folder.
Ja.
Zometeen om de hoek zet nog de magische C voor het paspoort en daarna kunt u lekker aan doen.
Ja.
Hoi!
Is je geboekt of niet?
Ja!
Ja, hè? Ik volg je echt mega lang op YouTube.
Oh, echt? Oh, grappig. Rij je ook motor?
Ja, klopt.
Wat rij je?
Z1000.
Ja, dit is de CRF 300 Rally.
Oké.
Okay. Dus ik ga hem nu eigenlijk hetzelfde als. Heb je seizoen 2 ook gekeken?
Ja.
Toen heb ik het ook gedaan. Eerst de motor naar Engeland rijden. En dan gaat hij vanaf daar op het vliegtuig. Dus ik ga terug naar Zuid-Amerika. Ja, dankjewel. Doei. Hi. Jo. Like that? Yeah, yeah, I know how it works.
Maybe you put it here because you want to strap it. Yes.
Can I also use this point?
Yes, easier.
Yeah, but the leaning is this side. It will never.
Huh? You
have two nodig. Oh, praat
geen
Ja, is goed. Ja, is goed.
Alaska is secured. Yeah, she'll be fine. Ready for the night? It's very quiet on the ferry, I've got to say. Now I have to figure out where I need to go. And remember where I put Alaska. Let me see, 338. Yes. Wow, look at that. Luxury. I have a view on an outside one. I have an outside cabin, or whatever you call it. Ah. All right, well, I'm super happy I made it on board because, well, there were so many paperworks and regulations and stuff. The UK is just, at the moment, really strict on who can enter and stuff. So I was a little bit nervous, of course, whether or not I could actually enter the UK now. Let me just get this off. So that's much better. I'm going to prepare to settle in for the night here. The boat's going to leave, or the ferry is going to leave at 10 o'clock tonight. And then tomorrow morning at 6:30 we arrive in the UK. So pretty exciting. I just spoke to the guy when I was strapping down Alaska. And he said the weather forecast was good, it's gonna be a quiet night, so let's hope he's right.
I'm in the UK. Thanks, bye. I'm here. It was a smooth sailing last night. Slept like a baby. So now it's about a 2-hour ride. Maybe a little bit more because I have to ride the whole ring road of London, obviously in morning rush hours, so let's see. Good morning.
Take your helmet in here.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
No, I'm just dropping my bike at Heathrow. Yeah. They will crate it and then send the bike to South America.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
Bye. Thanks. See if I have to do anything else, custom checks or something, maybe. So, no check, I think. I am in, I think. Back in the UK. Just going to stop over here to properly stow away my passports and put my gloves back on. Let's go! I mustn't forget to ride on the left side of the road. Left, 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 keep left. I am almost there. Sure, it was a cold morning. Oh, it's so cold, but I shouldn't complain because at least it is actually dry and the sun is out. So to be fair, it's been a beautiful morning riding here in the UK. I've just followed the highway, so nothing really interesting. But now I'm almost here. I think I recognize this point from last time that I was here. Let me see. In here. This looks very different from last time. Good morning. I'm looking for James Cargo.
What for?
To drop the bike.
You have to go straight down.
Yeah?
Last building on the left side.
Last building on the left. Okay. Thank you. I think this is new. I don't think this was here last time, to be honest. Can't remember. Must be this building. JCS. How are you?
Hi.
Good?
Good to see you.
Long time no see, huh?
Yeah. In ages, 2 years, I think, or so.
Where are we going now?
We're going to the warehouse, so I'm going to just...
You're going to show me? Yeah, okay. Okay.
Now just sitting on the bike to keep the suspension down a little bit, so the bike is a little bit smaller. So we're now just draining the tank of all the petrol, so the tank's empty, and we're disconnecting the battery, which is over here. It's actually not such easy access on this bike because you have to take out two bolts over here, and then you can take the seat off, and then you have to kind of remove this side panel because the battery is on that side. But all is good, and once that's done, then that means that the motorcycle can be shipped as normal cargo and you don't have to ship it as dangerous, hazardous.
Yeah, dangerous goods or hazards.
Dangerous goods or hazards. That makes it all a bit complicated with paperwork. So if you do this, then that's not necessary. Finished! Alaska is ready to go! Bye bye! Alright, Lucas from James Cargo just dropped me at the airport now. What an absolute legend! I just can't believe that they already completely created Alaska. She is already on her way also to the airport now. So yeah, super quick service. And he managed to get a flight for Alaska. Super, super quick. So yeah, super happy with it. A lot of supers. Anyway, where am I going? have to be, actually. Okay, I just sat on the airplane for 12 hours, but I made it. I am in Quito, Ecuador, and I will now I'm going to grab a taxi, and then I'll explain a little bit more on why I am in Quito, Ecuador, because this might come as a little bit of a surprise. Bye. Pago ahí. Sí.
¿En efectivo o tarjeta?
¿Cuánto vale por el centro histórico? $26. Sí. Okay. Gracias. Sí. Calle Venezuela. Yeah. So, I found myself a taxi. I'm now on the way to an Airbnb that I booked. Look at that. Oh, wow. Look at that sunlight coming through there. What an amazing view. Anyway, so I am in Ecuador, and you probably expected me to go back to Peru, where I stranded last time, and of course that was my plan. I just wanted to get back to where I ended last time and continue the ride. But Peru, all this time the borders were firmly shut all this time. So then I started looking, okay, what can I do then? So I decided to go to the next country, which is Ecuador. And by the time that I finalized all the arrangements for shipping Alaska and all of that, there was some news that Peru is apparently also reopening a little bit. But I think they'll probably first only open to fly in, but I think the land borders, they're probably still closed. I'm not entirely sure what's happening there, but anyway, by that time that I heard that news, I already set everything in motion to go to Ecuador. So, all is good. I am so super excited to be here. Honestly, it's a long flight, and actually the plane was full. That kind of came as a surprise. Yeah, how great to be here. I will probably have to acclimatize a little bit because Quito is actually at altitude. I'm not really sure how high. Maybe like 2,000 meters or something. ¿Usted sabe cuántos metros Quito está en?
2,850 metros de altura.
2,850 metros. Aquí en el aeropuerto, usted está 2,500. Okay, 2,500. But the center of Quito is actually a little bit higher at 2,850 meters. So it's quite high. So I think the coming days I'm just going to try to acclimatize a little bit, get used to the altitude. But actually, well, tomorrow I don't really have time to acclimatize because tomorrow Alaska is arriving. So the timing is like tight. So I'm now here. Tomorrow Alaska is going to arrive at the airport. So. Yeah, tomorrow I have to go and fetch her, collect her, do all the custom clearance and all of that. So that's going to be a little bit of a mission probably. I'm just going to take the taxi to town, find my Airbnb, and then in the next video I'll show you where I'm staying and yeah, show you kind of fetching Alaska. Hopefully it will go very, very smooth. So anyway, I'm so excited to be here and I can't wait to start riding. The weather, I've been looking at the weather forecast the last weeks and it is like cloudy and rainy a little bit, but the temperature is nice. It's like 19 degrees Celsius, so temperature is good. Probably get some rain every now and then, but hey, all is good. We are back on the road. So I really hope you liked this video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe down below, and then I'll see you in the next video.